Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm going to talk today about Jan Smuts and his speech to Parliament. And it was a legendary speech to Parliament back in 1942. And the two divisions in Parliament, the House of Commons and the House of Lords, both came to listen to his speech. All the members of Parliament came. He was given like a red carpet welcome to the UK when he came to visit the UK during World War II. Because, okay, first of all, he commended the people of the UK for standing up to Hitler. And despite being bombed all the time, as the UK was in 1940, and the food rations that had to get cut, and the relatives that they saw die on the streets because of the bombing, basically, but the response was, God bless England. That they didn't whine in the face of adversity, they didn't tremble, they stood up to Hitler and his tyranny. And he talked about the suffering that that Hitler's Gestapo inflicted on lots of people, and it was one of the greatest tyrannies of modern times, which it was. Now, the Soviet Union, during and after World War II, killed just as many, if not more, people. That continued after World War II, and after the Nazis were taken care of, the U.S. took care of the Soviets' communist problem. But the Nazis were more of an immediate atrocity that needed to be dealt with. And so Jan Smuts was right. I mean, Hitler's Gestapo was just outright evil, and they needed to be taken care of and needed to be brought to justice. And times have changed now, and China's an oppressor, not an oppressee. But back during World War II, it was different. China, since 1937, had suffered brutally at the hands of the Japanese in that brutal occupation. Things have changed now. Japan's a democracy. Japan wants peace in the Pacific, and China wants war. It's the complete opposite now, but back during World War II, it was a lot different. And Jan Smuts pointed that out about how China was suffering at the hands of a deadly Japanese occupation, which he was right to point that out. And he said when he came to England in 1942 to visit, that it was a free England, and he didn't know that during the pioneer days. You know, during the days of the Boer War, the British oppressed the Afrikaners, but he said by World War II, a lot of that changed, and he noticed a free England, an England where democracy reigned, which was excellent. And after Smuts' speech to Parliament, he was given a song. He was given a song by Parliament. They sang for him for "He's a Jolly Good Fellow," which nobody can deny. And Smuts was. He had a clear distinction between right and wrong. He was a devout Christian. He believed in helping others, and he believed in serving others. He believed in peace for the world. He didn't want another world war to happen, if possible. That's one reason he helped find the United Nations after World War II. He didn't want another world war to happen, if possible. Another world war not to happen, but at the same time be able to stand up to evil. Anyways, hope everybody's doing well. Take care. God bless them. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.